We're back with a KION special report tonight. The COVID-19 pandemic has impacted the way we live for nearly a year now, changing the way we touch, how we interact with our friends and family, and how we spend our holidays. All of this change can be a huge weight for many mentally and emotionally. KION's Josh Cristianto reports on the effort to help people push through.
Depression, anxiety, loneliness, despair. The COVID-19 pandemic has changed the way most Californians go about their daily lives.
People who are already, are dealing with a lot of mental health issues are having a particularly difficult time now, too, because, with COVID, people are feeling isolated and that sense of isolation is really doing a number on a lot of good people.
The National Alliance on Mental Illness in Monterey County has been trying to help residents with feelings of anxiety and depression lately. The national group reported a 65% jump in helpline calls and emails between March 1st and April 30th last year.
We're getting a substantial number of people calling us more than usual, particularly in the last quarter.
COVID-19, I definitely have seen an uptick in my practice of people coming in with just a lot of feeling overwhelmed, anxious, worried. Schools, I work with teens, and a lot of parents and my teen clients are really struggling with the online school.
Peter Binnings is a licensed clinical social worker who works as a therapist in the Santa Cruz area. He's noticed as the pandemic drags on, so do the emotions. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, just 3 months into the start of the pandemic in the U.S., 40% of American adults already reported struggling with mental health or substance abuse.
As a crisis continues and gets prolonged, it gets complicated, and people get burned out. They're not quite sure what to do. They kind of isolate more. They pull in more. They get angry. They get frustrated a lot more, and they feel really stuck and hopeless.
31% reported anxiety or depression symptoms. 11% said they seriously considered suicide.
A lot of people are suffering quite a bit right now, and it is a hard time, and it's important to acknowledge that and not try to fix that per se, not say, okay, here's a solution.
Experts say if you are feeling worried about yourself and your loved ones, or if you've experienced difficulty sleeping, changing in your eating patterns, or a worsening of any chronic health problems, it's important to find ways to cope. The first step is to recognize you may need help and to reach out.
Best ways to heal yourself is that you know you're not alone. You can pick up tips from other people. So yeah, I think it's always take care of yourself and then reach out to others for help is really important right now.
In my practice, I work with people a lot around acceptance, and that's a concept about kind of being able to accept difficult and hard things that we don't have control over. Doesn't mean we're okay with it, but it's helpful to kind of accept that.
Reporting in Salinas, Josh Cristianto, KION News Channel 546.